nation isn't lucky enough. Salute to Kashmir's Myers. Buckle up gamers, COD's new update is coming soon. Hilarious guidelines in North Korea. Stay tuned to know more.
Hello, my name is Ladvinath and you're watching the WYM Daily News.
Engineer duo's hydroponic setup. Shyamati Baska, an electrical engineer from Kolkata, and Lovekes Balachandani, a mechanical engineer from Indore, developed a solar-powered hydroponic fodder unit for rural farmers for their master's project at the TERI School of Advanced Studies, Delhi. Requiring 95% less water than a traditional fodder production, this unit takes just 8 days from seed to feed with zero downtime owing the soilless nature of this enterprise. Moreover, in a given month, this unit just needs 0.5% of electricity. First COVID-19 patient tests positive again. India's first COVID-19 patient has tested positive for the second time. She was all set to go to New Delhi for study purposes. Her samples were tested and the RT-PCR result turned out to be positive. She is currently at home and her health is fine as she does not have any symptoms. I guess her luck is bad and I hope she doesn't get infected again. I request all of you to take all precautions and prevent any travel. Don't depend only on vaccinations, as health is first. Widows of Bhopal gas leak to get 1,000 rupees extra pension. On Tuesday, the Madhya Pradesh cabinet decided to provide an additional pension of rupees 1,000 per tragedy victim. The decision was to take despite the objections of the finance department. Narottam Mishra told that the earlier BJP government started this pension in 2013. And now the present ruling government has decided to resume it. It's no sweat. Yesterday, gyms in South Korea's capital, Seoul, and its surroundings region were told not to play music with a tempo higher than 120 beats per minute in order to limit the spread of COVID-19. These new guidelines hilariously tries to control the music of gym members. A silent salute to those who bring earphones. The government even went as far as to limit maximum speed on treadmills, although the intentions of those guidelines are much welcome. Their effectiveness have met with various memes and jokes throughout social media platforms. Sunny side up. Solar winds are powerful storms that travel throughout the solar system at a speed of over 1 million miles per hour and mess with our planet's natural electromagnetic field. You might have already seen or heard about them in form of those beautiful lights called the Northern Lights or Southern Lights. Today, a solar storm is expected to hit the Earth at about a speed of 1 million kilometers per hour, tampering with our satellites and communication equipment orbiting the Earth, and hence GPS, power supplies and phone signals will be down. Call of Duty Black Ops, Cold War and Warzone to get the Season 4 reloaded update on July 15th. Gamers, get ready! Call of Duty Black Ops, Cold War and Warzone will get the Season 4 reloaded update on July 15th. This will add more content to what the Season 4 update from June 17th introduced. Call of Duty Warzone will get an objective-based game mode called the Payload, a new event, Killstreak, gifting mechanics and more. People are excited for this and so are we. So gamers, buckle up, get it done and call your homies for a match. Vivo patents a smartphone with an integrated flying camera. Vivo has reportedly filed a patent for a smartphone with an integrated flying camera. The camera will have the ability to detach from the smartphone and fly in the air to enable users to take photos creatively. The camera is a module. Is also equipped with a multiple infrared sensors at the edges to calculate the distance to other objects and avoid collisions. Vivo could introduce a stabilizing gimbal system inside the cameras to enable less shaky footage, but the impact might be limited. I wish I had one of them. Kashmir Martyrs Day. If you've always believed the tensions in Kashmir has its root in the partition of British India, then you tell us that it had started 16 years before the partition of India and Pakistan. On July 13, 1931, the first ever organized communal massacre in the history of modern Kashmir took place. The rioters who lost their life are today hailed as martyrs. After the formation of India, the state government of Jammu Kashmir officially announced the dead as fallen heroes. Since then, 13th of July is marked as Kashmir's Martyrs' Day.